Hi, my name is Linda Nell. I'm a 400-meter hurdler running for South Africa. We're heading to the Olympic Games later in August. My personal best in this event is 54.37 seconds, and I hope to break that in the Olympic Games. I've realized that with my last race, heading into the Olympic Games, I ran my season's best. So I do believe the energy is getting more and more, and I think at the Games, the adrenaline and the hype and the crowd will just motivate you to run your best.
Yeah, what's the best moment on the track for you?
I'm sure there's more than one, but the first one that comes to mind will be the semi-final at the World Champs last year in Beijing. I think the adrenaline was so high, and I really, really wanted to make that final, and I just had a chase in that last 100 meters straight, even if it was with my wrong leg. I chased for that second place to secure my spot, and I think that's quite a special moment. Even if it's not my best time, the specific race was something I will always remember. Stress can be a good thing. I think you should just try and manage it to put it into positive energy. So I will always just try and relax myself, listen to music, read a book just to calm myself. But on the race day, there will always be a little bit of stress, but usually most of the times for me it's exciting stress, and I've managed to put that into positive energy. I think the world has made Olympics such a big thing, especially in the sporting world, and for any sports person that can participate at the Olympics, that is, I believe, one of their biggest dreams. And for me, it has been a dream since I can remember, and when I thought that it's a realistic dream to chase, especially the last six to eight years. So for me, it will be just that exciting feeling of I can be on a world stage amongst the world's best athletes. Competing at the Olympic Games will be such an honor for me to represent South Africa.
And you've obviously been to these big games. What's the Olympic Village going to be like, and what's the feel amongst athletes?
I've heard the vibe's amazing, so I think it's just important to know why you are there and keep your focus and not get carried away too much about all the different free stuff and things that's happening around you. But like I said, I do believe I've gained enough experience to be able to handle that. Yes, disappointment is something I do believe any athlete will come across somewhere in their sporting career. And for me, I definitely had a lot of disappointments in my sporting career. But if I look back now, if I had to stop after a disappointing year, then I wouldn't have achieved where I'm at this moment. So for me, it's all about just keeping that hope and that dream, that the passion that you have for the sport, just to keep on going and believe that tomorrow will be another day. So I will also like to motivate younger athletes out there to, no matter the disappointment, there can be greater things that lies ahead in the future. So just keep on going.
My passion for athletics, it was there since I can remember, and that's usually where I go back to. Why did I start in the first place? So I started as a very young girl, loving the sport, enjoying the sport, and I never felt pressurized to do it from my family or friends, and they just supported me no matter what, with the ups and the downs. And I think that is something that carried me quite far, because I'm doing it because I enjoy it. It's not because someone tells me to do it, or I have to do it, or I have to perform. So whenever I go down in the blocks at big races, that is what I try to remember. I'm doing it because it started with a passion in my heart, and it's a God-given talent. So I really want to just live it out.
Lovely, Venda. There you have it, guys. Venda Nell heading to the Olympic Games in Rio in a few weeks' time. What a race. We only did 30, 40 odd meters, and you can see Venda's a supreme athlete. I'm looking forward to seeing her in Rio. Remember, this is not my main event.